All right, my good people, welcome to Play Along with Fancy Fingers. It's been a long time since I did tutorials, and I mean, now that I have time, we're all locked up in our houses, and I decided, let me now catch up with the songs that I hadn't done in a while. I think it's been like 2 years since I did any other tutorial, and we've done so many songs since then. So we will start with Susanna, will be the first one, since every time I go live, people are just asking for Susanna. Every time I post something, people are asking for Susanna, Susanna tutorial. So today we will do Susanna tutorial. This is our latest single of our upcoming album, Midnight Train. So the song is on A major, as most of you instrumentalists already know. It's a very simple song actually. So that's the key is A. So there's a riff that goes throughout the song from beginning to end that is very captivating, and the riff is quite simple. It just starts like it's on a major scale. So I usually play it from the fifth fret. You can play it from the open A string if you want. Whatever you feel works for you. So if you start on the fifth fret, so you will go. That's do re mi re fa, do re mi re fa. Very easy. So fa so fa, fa so fa so fa mi re re mi re di do. So do re mi re fa. So it's just the major scale, which is. So I add a little spice to it by using hammer offs, especially where there's a semitone space between the notes, which is between mi fa and ti do. So between mi fa. I hammer off mi, I hammer off fa into mi, then to re, so just for some spice. So that's the first cycle, and then so that starts from the higher do. So that means you land on the 6, which is an F sharp, the 6 of A. So okay, so on the last bar there's a bit of a switch in the playing. So that's do mi. So do mi re mi fa da di da 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 da. So I'll play the whole cycle. So the song starts. That's one. So that's it. That's basically what drives the song from beginning to end. It's just the same thing over and over again. And then now there's the when the song begins, there's the part that people really like, which is like a bang. So it starts. The A and you bang on the F sharp. That's it. It's that simple. So the song goes like this from the first verse. The verses are the same, and then now the chorus, which now we go an octave higher. In between this, there's some interludes that play after each chorus. So that's where we go. an octave higher, and then we play I think it's from from the re. So there's a whole cycle. So so that's just an octave higher of A, which is the A is right there. So something like that. I'm not sure if that's exactly the same, but something like that. So that is just the same thing. Play an octave higher. Make sure you start when you play, because you're playing I think two beats before the bar begins. So the bar starts from the one, but then you lead into the one, which is now playing this it's a pentatonic, I think, from the re. So yeah, that's it. Yeah, so it's just the same thing, move an octave higher, that's it. And that's the post-chorus groove that we hear. And then now we have what other part? Chimano's part. So, how does it go? Oh yeah, the progression of the chord, actually, because I just played the riff. So the progression is very simple. Just 1-4, 1-4-5-1. Yeah, I'm trying to play the chords and the riff at the same time. Also play the riff here in the, from the beginning. As I said, you can play with this open string, the A open string, or you can play from the fifth fret. Whatever you choose, whatever rocks your boat, just do you. And then Chimano's part. Now there's a place now I join him in his verse. Actually, let me just look for it and play it so you guys can hear. All right, so he's coming. That's 4-5, which is EA plus bangs. Then 6. Then yeah. So if I could just take you through that. So you start just playing the same melody that he's singing. Then so there's like a half bend there, which is like a dominant seventh that I'm adding to his verse. So yeah, you can slide to that note, which is a dominant seven, or you can bend to it. Yeah, and that's it. And then the end of the song is basically the same thing again as the pre-chorus is, with just a few embellishments to it at the end. But now the main part of the song, as I said, is what I did in the beginning, is just this riff. it, guys. Very simple song. Play along. Ask any questions you want on the comments. You can DM me, whatever it is. I would also like to learn from any of you guys. Whatever ideas you have, please send them through. Let's just share. And yeah, stay safe. Remember to wash your hands. Sanitize. And stay at home. Yes, and as you do that, as you wash your hands and sanitize and do all that and stay at home, don't forget to subscribe on this channel right here, Salty Soul. We have so much content for you, from all of us individually to, you know, the group as a whole. So just make sure you subscribe, and we won't disappoint you, for sure.